WordPress.com versus WordPress.org. If you're considering starting a blog, you may be looking at one of these two options, but you may be confused as to which one is right for you. So let's compare both options. Hey, my name is Sarah from Business Women Thrive, and in today's video, we are going to be comparing WordPress.com versus WordPress.org. Both of them have good sides and downsides, so we're going to be looking at the differences, the pros and cons, and the prices of each of them. The first difference is how you build your site, and this one is a pretty major difference between the two. On WordPress.org, you have to first buy hosting from a hosting company and a domain name, and then you can download the WordPress software from there, because the software itself is free, but you have to buy a domain name and you have to buy hosting first before you can get access to using the software. But on the .com version, there is no extra steps to buying hosting or things like that. You can just create your site right from the WordPress.com dashboard. The second difference is the price, and this is also drastically different depending on the different things that you get. And just as a side note, any of the things that I mentioned in today's video, I will leave all of the resources linked in the description below. So if you want to check out anything that I've mentioned today, just go ahead and check out the description. All the links will be in there. First, let's check out the things that you would need for a WordPress.org site. And this in itself is going to be drastically different because it really depends on a lot of different factors for what your total price is going to be. But let's take a look at the things that I have bought for my WordPress.org site first. The first thing you have to buy, like I mentioned, is hosting. This is really the only thing that you absolutely need to start a blog. You can't start a WordPress.org site without hosting. And everything else that you get is just useful extras. I get my hosting from SiteGround, and plans range from $6.99 a month all the way up to $14.99 a month. And honestly, all you need to start out is the basic plan. This is still the plan that I have to this day. The second critical thing that you need is a domain name, but this kind of wraps in with your hosting because you can't buy hosting without buying a domain name. When you buy hosting from SiteGround, you can also buy a domain name with them, and this is going to be the www.com of your site. But if you're looking to switch hosting companies and you already have a domain name with SiteGround, you can bring your domain name with you. And I'm pretty sure that's true for all the hosting companies. If you have the hosting company somewhere else and you're looking to switch to a better hosting company, you can take your domain name with you, and then you won't have to pay for the domain name when you sign up for SiteGround. But if you don't have a domain name and you're just starting, you can buy it from SiteGround directly. It's just a little extra button that you click when you sign up. It's super easy. All you have to do is make sure that you have a domain name that isn't taken. The third thing that I bought was a website theme. This is something that you don't technically need because you can use a free website theme, but I recommend if you have the money for it that you actually buy a premium theme and install it yourself. I bought all of my website themes from either Creative Market or Etsy. And you can find some pretty cheap themes on Creative Market. You can find some really expensive ones, but the ones that I have all bought have either been $25 to $45. So if you have an extra $25 to spend, I would highly recommend checking out Creative Market for a premium theme. But the grand total for everything that I just mentioned in a year is $124.83. And this isn't everything that I've actually bought from my blog. This is just those three or four essential items that you actually need. But now let's check out the plans that you can get with WordPress.com. So there is a free plan for WordPress.com. You don't have to pay anything to get started. You can just sign up and start creating your blog. That's actually the plan that I started out on years ago. And if you like that, you can upgrade to a personal plan, which is $4 a month. They also have a premium plan for $8 a month, a business plan for $25 a month, and an e-commerce plan for $45 a month. And each of these come with all their own features. There are honestly too many features to get into, but you can just look up WordPress.com prices and you can see for yourself what all of the features are if you're looking into this option. Next, I want to get into the pros and cons of each site. And the first one we're going to look at is WordPress.org pros. The first pro is you own your site. When you buy a .org site, you own your site because you pay for it. Nobody can tell you what to do with your site. You can do any monetization strategies that you want. You can change anything. You can add anything. You could take away anything. You could literally do whatever you want with it, and nobody can take it down from you or it away from you. And that's really the most important thing to me, because if this is going to be my baby, like if this is going to be, if my blog is going to be something that I'm spending all of this time on, I want to be able to do whatever I want with it, and I want to have complete and total control and freedom over my business, because this is going to be my livelihood. So that is one of the most important things to me with the WordPress.org site, is that you own it. Whereas on WordPress.com, you don't own your site. The second thing is there is more flexibility. And I kind of mentioned this in the last point, but you can do whatever it is you want with your WordPress.org site. If you want to change the theme, if you want to change the hosting company, if you want to add a plugin, if you want to completely recode your entire site, anything that you want to do, you can do, because you own it. You are the owner, you are the boss, basically. And I love that you can really run your business the way that you want to without having anybody really tell you how you have to do it. Now let's get into the WordPress.org cons, because as much as I love using WordPress.org, there are some cons if you are in a certain situation. And the first one is basically you're going at this alone. Like, there is no help, really. There's no manual for how to start a blog. Like, there are tons and tons of different ways that you can start a blog, and there's tons of different resources online, but essentially it's up to you to do this yourself. Like, you don't have someone holding your hand through this, really. If a plugin breaks, you have to fix that plugin yourself. You have to choose the hosting company. You are making all the decisions. If you decide to code your site and it breaks your site, you know, there is going to be some help. Like I mentioned, the resources and stuff online, there's going to be some help there and your hosting company, and maybe you can get into plugin support. But other than that, a lot of the decisions you're going to have to make and figure out how to fix on your own. So if that is something that you are not interested in yet and you are not really ready to run your own site, then WordPress.org might not be the place for you to run your blog right now. And the last thing is the price. It really depends what you get, but running a blog on WordPress.org can be pretty expensive. And if you really don't have the money to shell out for this stuff, especially the price tag that I mentioned, that $124, that is not even everything that I have ever bought from my blog. I have bought courses and books and plugins and a lot of other extras. So this is a huge price tag if you are really serious about running your blog. And in the beginning, you are not going to be getting really a consistent income. It's going to take a long time for you to get a consistent income. So if you don't have the disposable income right now, this might not be the best option for you. Next, I want to get into the pros of WordPress.com, because even though this isn't the option that I recommend, there are some pros to it. The first thing is the tech support. There is a little bit more tech support on WordPress.com than there is with WordPress.org, because there is actually a tech support for WordPress.com that you can email. I'm not really sure how to get in contact with them. I believe it's through email. I've never actually personally had to contact them, and I'm not sure how helpful they are, but I do know that they are there if something is wrong, because you are hosting your blog on their servers, so they can help you with any questions that you have. And running a WordPress.com site is a lot less involved, because you technically aren't the owner. You are hosting your blog on their servers, so you don't have to pick a theme if you don't want to. There is no plugins that you can download and things like that. Your site is just there. It's just really easy to set up. The next pro is you can sign up for free for WordPress.com. This honestly to me is a pro and a con, because with it being free, it's a free site. Like, you don't get a lot for a free site because you're not paying for it. You know, the less you pay for something, the less kind of quality that it's going to be. So this kind of is a con to me. But if you are looking to start a blog and you're not sure if it's really the best thing for you, and you're not sure you really want to commit to it, you can start a blog for free. And you can do, you know, you can do a lot of amazing things on WordPress.com if that is the site that you want to go with, or if that is the situation that you're kind of in right now. I started my blog on WordPress.com, and it got me into this blogging journey from 2018 that has now evolved into an entire business. So it's really like a good first stepping stone to kind of dip your toes into the water of blogging and decide if you actually like it, so that you're not shelling out $124 a year before you even decide if you like it. Now let's get into the cons. The first thing is the pay to play, because while there is a free option for WordPress.com, it's pretty limiting. Like I said, you get what you pay for, and what you're paying for is literally nothing if you get the free option. If you're like me, you might find yourself wishing that you had more. When I first started on WordPress.com, I had never heard of a .org site. I thought this is what people were doing, so I was really confused as to why my blog didn't look the same, why I didn't have the same cool features, why my themes didn't look as nice. I couldn't figure out why I didn't look like other bloggers, because I thought they were all on WordPress.com. I didn't realize WordPress.org was a thing. So you'll eventually find yourself wishing you had a better theme, you had the cool plugins that people have, you wish you had a custom domain name, because with the free version, you don't get a custom domain name. It will be www.yourdomainname.wordpress.com. So you don't even get a regular domain name unless you upgrade. On WordPress.com, you have to upgrade to be able to download plugins, and I believe you might even have to pay for those plugins as well, as opposed to getting free plugins with WordPress.org. I don't think you can download a custom theme even if you pay for it. You can't get Google Analytics. You have to use the Jetpack version of Google Analytics, which is slower and not as reliable as Google Analytics. You have to use WordPress ads. You cannot put Google ads on there or upgrade to Mediavine ads or something like that when you get more traffic. There's some customization options. There's just a ton of customization options that you can't do, and there's some even monetization options that you can't do. Or it may be harder to get approved for because you have that free blog link. There is just so many cool features that you unfortunately don't get with the free version, or you have to pay to get, and then it's still not as worth it as if you had went with a WordPress.org site. So with all that information, let's summarize and pick which one is best for you. How do you know when you should go with WordPress.org? Because there are certain situations in which I would wholly recommend WordPress.org, and I generally do that anyway, but there are some situations where I wouldn't. So, what situations would I recommend WordPress.org in? WordPress.org may be better for you if you have the money. As I mentioned earlier, a .org website can get pretty expensive, and if you don't have that disposable income, you might not be able to afford it right now. But like I mentioned as well, it also depends on the hosting you use, the theme that you get, the plugins that you download. It really depends on the extras that you get. So it can be cheap depending on what you actually buy for your blog. And WordPress.org may be better for you if you are serious about making money blogging. If you are serious about making money blogging and even turning it into a side income or a full-time income, you don't even want to look at WordPress.com. However, WordPress.com may be better for you if you're looking to just blog as a hobby. If you're thinking that this is just going to be something fun that you dabble in from time to time and you just want to put up some nice stories online, or you want to dabble in writing or something like that, WordPress.com would be better for you. Because if you're just doing this as a hobby and you don't plan on making money from it, I really don't suggest dumping a bunch of money into a hobby if you can do that hobby for free. And because you can switch over to a .org site if you want. I made the switch myself. It's not necessarily easy per se, unless you can get your hosting company to do it for you, which I think a lot of hosting companies nowadays will make the switch from a WordPress.com to a WordPress.org site for you. I'm not sure, it really depends what hosting company you go with, but if you decide to eventually upgrade to a .org site, you can do that. So that is something to consider if you're looking into WordPress.com, is you can always make the switch later if you decide that's something that you want to do. Whichever one you choose, I hope you choose the blogging option that is best for you. And remember, anything that I mentioned in this video or any other resources that I have that will help you get started will all be linked down below in the description so that you can go through and check them all out if you're interested. Don't forget to like if you liked and subscribe to my channel down below for more videos just like this one. And I will see you next Thursday. Bye!